Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install MongoDB database. So I'll be showing you how to download MongoDB server as well as MongoDB shell and MongoDB compass. So I'll be showing you these three things. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type MongoDB download, and if you just scroll down you'll be having this link over here as MongoDB community server download. Just click that. It will take you to the MongoDB community server. Now if you just scroll down you'll be having the 6.0.3 version of platform Windows, and you need to select the package as MSI. If you want zip you can select zip. I will go with the MSI itself, and this is the latest version. Okay, so just click on download. So it is about 482 MB in size, so please wait till the download gets completed. So once the download is completed just click on open. Yeah, you'll be getting the MongoDB setup over here, so just click on next and just click on I accept. If you want you can just read it through. Just click on next and just go with complete. Okay, just click on complete. All the program features will be installed. Complete is best, I guess. And here is an important thing. Okay, you need to have this install MongoDB as a service. You need to check this. Okay, don't uncheck this and run service as a network service. This everything is fine over here. Okay, don't uncheck or modify any of these things. So just click on next. And here is also another important thing. Don't uncheck this, because by this way we can directly install MongoDB compass rather than going and again like going to the site and downloading it. Here we can check that directly. So just check that as well. It will be checked by default and click next and just click on install. So once the setup is over you'll be having your MongoDB compass. It will get automatically opened. So I'll just close it. Yeah, so this is your MongoDB compass right now. So before that, let's first go and add the environmental path variables, alright? So I'll just close it at first. So now you need to go to the path where you have installed MongoDB server. So for that, you need to go to C, Program Files, and here you will be having MongoDB. Just click it. You need to go to Server 6.0, and you need to go to Bin. So you need to just copy this entire path, Control C, and you need to go to environment variables. Just type en, you'll be having the option called as edit the system environment variables. Just click on open and you need to go to environment variables. Here you'll be having a path under system variables. Just select that and click on edit, click on new, and you need to just paste the path. So you need to copy it till bin. Okay, MongoDB server, the version and bin. Okay, be careful and just click on okay. Okay, everywhere pretty much. So I will just now minimize it and I will just go to my command prompt cmd. If I just now zoom in a bit and if I type MongoD hyphen hyphen version, so to check that we have like added the right path in our environment variables, just click enter. So we will be getting this way. So we are not getting any errors, which means that we have added the right path. So after this, just type the command MongoD and hit enter. So here you can see our process has exited with an error. So it says exit code. And the reason is because, so here you can see that error non-existing path data directory C data slash DB. So we need to create this particular folder path in our system. So it's going to be local disk C data and DB. So I will just do that now. So I will go to my local disk C and it has said to create a folder name as data. So just right click, click on new folder. You need to name it with a small d data, and inside that just go and click new again folder have DB. Okay, so after this is done we can just close this and restart our command prompt, and let me just zoom in a bit again. So this time if I type MongoD, so here you can see this time like I'm not getting any errors and it has started. So this is fine now. So let me just now close it. And in case if you want to start a service for MongoDB, what you can do is you can just search for services and you need to just scroll down. So in some cases because of some security protections your services won't start, so you can also start it manually. So here you will be having in the yum, here you can see right MongoDB server. So if this is not running, you need to just right click and start the service. Okay, this needs to be running. So now we are done with these things. So next thing we will be installing the MongoDB shell. Okay, so I'll just go here, go to Google and type MongoDB shell. You'll be having this MongoDB shell download, the first link. Just click on that. And if you just scroll down, you'll be having the MongoDB shell download. Yeah, this is fine. So this is by default a zip package. Okay, there isn't any MSI. So just click on download. So it's like so small in size, 34 MB. So you're done. So I'll just go to my downloads folder. Yeah, this is here. Right click, extract all, extract. So this is done. So if you want, you can just cut this and paste in your local disk C drive. Yeah, so this is fine. So now if I just go into Mongosh, so we need to add this particular path in our environment variable as well. So just go inside bin. So this is that particular path, okay? C Mongosh, Mongosh, some big name and bin. Copy this, same thing. Type en, you'll be getting the edit the system variables, open, and you need to click on environment variables, path, edit, new, paste the path again. So two paths, be careful there. Okay, apply it as well now. Okay, so this is fine. So if I just now go to my command prompt, and if I just zoom in a bit and type Mongosh, so here you can see, right, we will be getting the MongoDB shell available. So this is now connected to our local MongoDB compass or MongoDB server. So here you can see, right, this is the local host path, and here you can run any MongoDB queries or commands. So first I will like create a database and insert some values inside it. So for creating database, we just have the use command in MongoDB. There isn't any create commands like in MySQL. So it's going to be use. Let me name my database as newDB. Yeah. So I am in that particular database now. So now let me show you how to insert a value inside a collection. So collection is nothing but a table in MongoDB. So it's going to be db dot the collection name. I will go with new collection dot insert. And within that, just have your key and value pairs. So I'll go with name, that is going to be my key, and I will go with value. Okay, so colon and hit enter. So here you can see I'm getting acknowledged true, which means that this value has been inserted. So you can also use insert one or insert many, like that's your choice. So now if I go to my MongoDB compass, okay, so I will just go to my MongoDB compass, and if I just click on connect, so this is how you will be getting. Don't modify anything, okay, it's connected to localhost. Just click on connect, and here you can see I'm having new DB, and if I just go inside it, here I'll be having my collection, and I'll be having this value over here. So if I just do it again, so I'll just run the exact same command with hello guys like that and hit enter. So you need to again go to your compass, and here you'll be having option to refresh. Just click on refresh, so you'll be getting this value. So you need to have MongoDB shell, through that you can like directly have commands. And in order to view those particular queries, you can get help use of the GUI interface, that is MongoDB Compass. So this is like super helpful in viewing your database and stuff. And I think that's it pretty much. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in Node.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, as well as C, C++, Java, Python. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.